Universal Center for Renovation presents Historical Israelites. This is strictly for educational purposes and commentary of biblical and secular historical literature. So enjoy. Also, don't forget to subscribe, like, and share. UNCR, Universal Center for Renovation. And ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. John 8:32. The former free Romans were transferred en masse from the cities and were established on the slave labor camps called Villae and Massi alongside the serfs. They were called villeins, a term which, for understandable reasons, came to mean enemies of law and order, Frank feudalism and doctrine, page 7. The slave labor camps were called villae, villas, and mansi, mansions, or manors. Wiktionary, villae, plural of villa, villae, villa. Wikipedia, villa. A villa is a type of house that was originally an ancient Roman upper class country house. Villae, villa. Post-Roman era. In post-Roman times, a villa referred to a self-sufficient, usually fortified, Italian or Gallo-Roman farmstead. It was economically as self-sufficient as a village, and its inhabitants, who might be legally tied to it as serfs, were villeins. The Romans were the serfs, and the villeins of medieval times, the Dark Ages. The slave labor camps were called villae, villas, and mansi, mansions, or manors. Wikipedia, villains. A villain is a class of serf tied to the land under the feudal system. As part of the contract with the lord of the manor, they were expected to spend some of their time working on the lord's fields in return for land. Villeins existed under a number of legal restrictions that differentiated them from free men and could not leave without his lord's permission. Generally, villeins held this status not by birth, but by the land they held. And it was also possible for them to gain manumission or freedom from their lords. The villainage system largely died out in England in 1500, with some forms of villainage being used in France until 1789 or the French Revolution. Villains could not leave the land without permission. The villains of England were free by 1500 AD, but the ones in France were not free until 1789, the French Revolution. Villains could not leave the land they were born on. Etymology. Villain was a term used in the feudal system to denote a peasant, tenant farmer, who was legally tied to a lord of the manor. The majority of medieval European peasants were villains. An alternative term is serf. Serf. Despite this originating from the Latin service, meaning slave, a villain was thus a bonded tenant. A bondman, a bond servant, or slave. So he could not leave the land without the landowner's consent. Villain is derived from late Latin, villainous, meaning a man employed at a Roman villa rustica, or large agricultural estate. The system of tied serfdom originates from a decree issued by the late Roman Emperor Diocletian, who ruled 284 to 305 CE. The decree obliged ordered peasants to register and their locality, and never leave it. Because of the low social status of villains, the term became derogatory. In modern French, villain means ugly or naughty. In Italian, landlord means rude or ill-mannered. Spanish, villano, neighbor or inhabitants of a village or town. But it also accepts the derogatory use, which is very similar to the modern English villain. Let's go over a couple of points. One, villain. Enslaved Roman denotes a peasant. Two, villain or peasants were by law bound to serve a Frankish lord on his villa or manor, his farm. Three, a serf, meaning slave, from the Latin service. 4. The system of serfdom originates from a decree issued by the Roman Emperor Diocletian, who ruled 284 to 305 AD. Emperor Diocletian originated the system of serfdom. What they never told you in history class, page 276. The famed scholar Bamba Gascoigne, in his book The Christians, provides us with a picture from the corner of St. Mark's in Venice, which has the statue of two 4th century porphyry emperors. Note the nose and lips of these emperors. They have definite African features. Page 276. Black people in ancient Roman history. Wikipedia. Black Romans. The Tetrarchs. Diocletian. Emperor Diocletian was one of the four Tetrarchs. A Roman identity did not suggest a given skin tone. Rather, it referred to an ever-shifting set of cultural traditions, growing more eclectic in later Roman history, to which inherited physical characteristics were of no relevance. The Black, or so-called Black Romans, including Diocletian, were originally Syria. Judea was called by the Romans Syria Palestina, Judea, Kingdom of Judah. Wikipedia. Judea. Judea is a mountainous region in the southern part of the modern states of Palestine and Israel. The name is an ancient historic biblical Hebrew, contemporaneous Latin, and modern day term originating from the Hebrew name Yehuda or Yahawada, a son of the biblical patriarch Jacob, also known as Israel, with Yahawada's or Yehuda's progeny forming the biblical Israelite tribe of Judah, Yehuda or Yahawada, and later the associated kingdom of Judah. In 132 AD, the province of Judea was merged with Galilee into an enlarged province named Syria Palestina. Syria, Palestina, Judea. Provincia, Syria, Palestina, Roman province, Syria, Palestina, also known as Judea.